Ladies and gentlemen, tonight, Bow Wow is on our panel. Rich the Kid is breaking in our performance stage, and I'm catching up with an old friend, ASAP Rocky. Complex is staying open late. Yes, good evening. Thank you, everyone. One time for A-Rap Music. He will be here every week holding it down on the MPC. And I'm your host, Peter Rosenberg. For those of you that don't know me, I've been on the radio for over a decade. And yes, I'm another white guy with a late night talk show. That is not lost on me. Believe me, not for a second. But unlike other talk shows, hosted by guys that look like me, we're actually going to talk on this show about real shit. No canned questions, no pre-produced answers, no controversial hot takes to provoke trolls. Okay, there might be some of that. I mean, I am Peter Rosenberg, for God's sake. But what we're really gonna do is have meaningful conversations with people contributing to the culture who have something to say. That's why we're staying open late. So here we are. A-Rap, give me a beat. Everywhere I go, everybody's talking about Cardi B. It's Cardi's moment. From magazine covers, to SNL, to co-hosting The Tonight Show, she's everywhere. The hits keep coming. An old woman on the Upper West Side actually came up to me the other day and said, oh, for no reason. Every woman I talk to relates to Cardi in some way. Something's happening that I've never seen in 20 years working in this business. But to me, what's truly remarkable is that she's even taken seriously at all. And that's not a comment on her, but on the world she's taken by storm. Far too often, porn stars, video girls, and strippers who try to go mainstream like Cardi are regarded and disregarded as lesser than because they're women that work in the world of sex. They're caricatures, punchlines. And you know how I know? Because I used to make those punchlines. Don't believe me? Ask Amber Rose. That's right, quick story. Several years ago when Amber announced she was writing a book, I went on the radio and was like, yeah, that's just what we need, a book from Amber Rose. Amber demanded that I take her seriously though. She hits me right away and is like, Rosenberg, I'm coming up there right now to talk to you. She told me how wrong I was and we ended up becoming close friends. Then she proved to the world that she should be taken seriously by starting a conversation about empowerment for women who weren't always included in those conversations. Strippers, video women, Stormy Daniels. So fast forward to 2016. Now you'd think I would have gotten the message, but of course you'd be wrong. Because when Cardi first started getting hot, I didn't take her seriously either. Thought her shtick was base and low end. I wasn't interested. I didn't give her a chance because of who she was and because of how she sounded. And just like I did with Amber, I totally got it wrong with Cardi B. And if me, a women's studies minor, that's a real thing by the way, I was, got it wrong and unfairly judged her, imagine how other people treated her. Which is exactly why we appreciate everything she's doing now, because she's become the belle of the ball without giving a fuck about what anyone thinks, least of all me. So that's what I want to talk about tonight. What exactly are we witnessing with Cardi B? Is it the rise of a great MC? Or simply the unfolding of a great story. Here to help me talk about it tonight and so much more, give it up for tonight's panel.
All right.
Okay, we have a lot to get to. So, I wanna start off by introducing my man. You may know him from Complex's social media or just walking around the Complex offices looking cool. Make some noise for Frazier, everyone.
Good.
Media personality, my dear friend, former co-host on Ebro in the Morning Hot 97, makes a noise for Scotty Beam. This next man, some people call him a legend. Some people call him an icon. Some people call him a troll. I call him a friend. Bow Wow is here, ladies and gentlemen. All right, so I want to start with you, Scotty Beam. Cardi B. Are we witnessing the birth and beginning of a great MC, or are you just in love with the whole story that is Cardi B?
I'm in love with both, you know what I'm saying? And she actually, I don't care who wrote for her, I don't care, there's tons of legends who have, you know, been written for. So I know, you know, I don't see what the problem is. Like, I know, I want a second album from Cardi B. This first album is great. To me, you know, I'm not gonna go as far as Pitchfork did and could give it an 8.7. That was
what would you give it? What would you?
Crazy.
Huh? What would you give it?
I would give it a, I'd give it an 8.0.
8.0, 8.0
even. I give it an 8.0.
All right, I wanna get to the MC last. Frazier, your take on Cardi.
Yeah, I've been a fan since, like, Lake. Lake was hard, and since then, she's just been getting better.
Bow Wow, now you are an MC. You write rhymes, you perform rhymes. You used to have writers as well,
absolutely,
right?
Absolutely, absolutely.
What do you think about Cardi as an MC?
I'm more in love with the hustle. I think that a lot of women could look at her for, you know, as inspiration too. I feel like her story is one of a kind. It's unique, and I think she's the first of to do it. Not the first, you know, female, because it's been other females that have stripped and became rappers, but I think the way she did it, she just maximized it, and she's on fire right now. I respect it.
Were you surprised? Did you think, think that it would happen?
No, I wasn't surprised.
Really?
Nah. Everybody could relate to what she was talking about. And I've been in Lust before when I hosted Lust and Cardi was dancing. And I'm like, that's the girl off the IG. Like, man, she can't dance. I don't, she can't come near us. Like, I don't know if she might.
Oh, got it. Because you knew she was popping.
This nigga Bow Wow came in here. They weren't spending no money. I'm like, man, we gonna keep that away.
Now are you admitting you were spending no money?
Yeah,
no,
right?
No, we was. I didn't want no mixture of that. But then I seen her. I started to see it. And I said, you know what? The era we live in and the times we live in, she gonna pop and she gonna blow. And she different. You know what I'm saying? Like, she different. She came in with no cosign. No cosign? Mm-hmm. Like, Nicki had tune. She had nothing.
Drake had tune.
She got played on Love & Hip Hop. She got dropped from DJ Self.
You feel me?
Yeah. Your background does not relate to Cardi's at all.
No.
Do you relate to Cardi in ways, though?
I do. I relate to being yourself. Being, like, authentic, period. And I love that. I love that she owns up to her shit. I love that she is completely and utterly herself all the time. And even when showing her face, like, with no makeup, looking busted on Instagram, she shows everything. So I love that about her. And I think that, you know, a piece of me is what I think all of us, especially women, a piece of us is with Cardi B. We don't necessarily have to be, like, you know, clapping it on the pole to get where she's coming from.
Frazier, did you ever clap it on the pole?
Oh, shit.
A couple weeks during college.
Looking thin.
Okay, but Frazier, yeah, you're a little thin for that.
You're a little thin.
No one trying to see that, Frazier. You get no money in the club. Frazier's the lonely stripper. No one. Now, right. Frazier, as a big rap fan and someone who studies it, though, where do you think the Cardi story goes?
I don't even know if she needs more albums after this.
But so you just one?
I think, like, her takeover is already on the charts.
See, but the funny thing is, I felt the same way he did before the album came out. Mm-hmm. When she got nominated for the Grammys, I went, maybe she doesn't even drop an album. She's like, I did my thing. But now the album's good, so why would she not keep coming back out? Like, there's no reason not to.
Well, also, I think this album has legs that we're not, like, we can't even imagine. Like, I Like It is gonna take over La Marina all summer.
Very fast.
A friend of mine and another known troll at times, Punch from TDE, jumped up on Twitter and said, quote, Cardi B is Tupac. Is this just a complete troll, or is there any sort of comparison you could make, Bow Wow, between Cardi B and Tupac?
I can't.
He went over my head with that one.
I can't think of one thing.
Yeah, I don't.
Can you?
I can try as far as maybe flow and delivery. Maybe. Like, I'm saying maybe.
Well, like the organic sort of, like, yelling and.
The yelling. And I don't think we're talking there, you know.
Just say no. All right, it's time to blow up my panel's mentions by getting all their scorching hot takes on the week's news. This is Major, Mage, or a Pug. All right, guys, I'm gonna hit you each with a story, and you decide whether the story is Major, Mage, or a Pug. We'll start here. Jay-Z and Beyonce's upcoming On the Run 2 tour will reportedly confront their marital issues. So, the question for you guys, the Carters airing out their dirty laundry on the road, Major, Mage, or Repug? Frazier.
Easily Major.
Major.
Instant classic.
Why? Oh, wow. Why do you feel it's an instant classic?
I mean, does Jay-Z miss? Not often.
All right.
Beyonce, even less often. I think what we have here is an opportunity to turn 444 and Lemonade into a perfect trilogy.
Scotty, your face, you may try to lie and come out and say major because you're scared of the
bees. I'm part of the beehive, and that's why I'm going to probably say mage.
Not major.
Not major.
Okay.
What I will say is Jay-Z has been on a whole I Cheated on My Wife tour. We've seen it. It was dope. We loved it. It was dope. I want to see Beyonce now. That's what I'm here for.
Okay.
Thank you. Clap it up for Beyonce.
What?
Thank you.
So you're just saying you don't want Hove cutting into your B time.
For real, that's all I want. I just want one Beyonce tour. Just give me a Beyonce.
All right, Bow Wow, Major, Mage, or a Pug for the Carters?
I think Mage. I kind of agree with, with Sis. I feel like it's been 2 years since Beyonce's been seen or been in concert. She was supposed to do Coachella. And I think that, it's her time now. I think that, she should come back on the Beyonce tour. Hov just got off tour with 6 months ago. And I think that it's B time.
I will go with Mage. And it's actually for a little bit agreeing with Frazier on this, which is I think there's a really nice part of it. I mean, we all ended up in the same place, Mage. I love Beyonce. Mm-hmm. I love Jay-Z. I like them together. Mm-hmm. Together, I actually, one of those things that I kind of like more separately than together. Love them as a couple, mm-hmm. but musically, I sort of like them separately.
No wrong.
That's it, I'll go with Mage. Mm-hmm. All right, Gucci Mane. He started a little bit of an issue this week with T.I.
Oh, shit.
When he claimed he invented trap music. Now, of course, Tip, never the one to back down, Ooh. Came back real quick, and they had a little bit of a sound off between the two Atlanta legends. So, Gucci's claim about inventing trap music, Major, Mage, or Repug? Bow.
This is Major. You know what I'm saying? This is Major, because you're talking about a sound that's really, it started out sounding like something, and now it just transcended into something totally different. You know what I'm saying? You hear with the Migos style, you hear Future style. But the first person that I heard trap music from was Tip. Mm-hmm. His first album,
All right.
You were talking about a record, Dope Boys in the Trap.
Bonafide Gucci stan, Scotty Beam.
Sure am.
What are your thoughts, Major, Major, or Pug?
Major.
Really?
Yeah, it's Major.
Absolutely.
I mean, first of all, I will never, ever discredit it. Like, T.I. is the king to me.
King of the South.
I went to school at Clark Atlanta University.
Did you finish? Sorry.
What I'm saying is, when I went there, I definitely saw the Gucci takeover. Mm-hmm. The Gucci takeover was insane. T.I. will always be the first, the daddy, the king, call him whatever. But Gucci made it better to me, in my eyes. He's the best.
Young Frazier, what are your thoughts?
I'm going to go Mage. I think instead of the two of them disagreeing over it, we just need him, Tip, and then throw Jeezy in. Or like a trap posse cut.
Like all on one track?
Yeah.
That'll never happen in life.
I'm gonna go Mage. I'm kind of hovering in the middle on this as well because trap music is trap music. Mm-hmm. And that talk, T.I. is so important. For me, he's who put me on, at least as a hip hop fan, that whole vibe. Mm-hmm. But I will say this, there's no bigger influence in the South than Gucci. All right, 2 Chainz posted a picture on Instagram the other day of him in the studio with the other king, not King of the South, LeBron James. Now, he may have been teasing LeBron rapping?
No.
Athletes rapping, Major, Mage, or Repug.
This one kind of tricky.
You got to think of who you're friends with, who's an athlete who started rapping. How tight are you with Shaq?
Okay, we'll put it this way. I think that, what Damian Lillard does, this thing, Dame is hard.
Yeah. True.
Damian Lillard is dope. You know what I'm saying?
Damian Lillard's got bars.
Yeah, I don't think that there's nothing wrong. If you can do it, you can do it.
Now, but what if LeBron did try to rap? Would that be Repug?
I mean, he do be on Instagram.
He does.
Yeah.
All right, Scotty.
I don't want to see Bron pick up the mic, though. I don't want to see LeBron pick up the mic.
Scotty, Major, Major, or Pug?
Repug. Repug. Repug for 400, Alex. I can't do it. There's no way I'll listen to a LeBron mixtape or anything like that. I'm against athletes rapping.
All right, Frazier, Major, Major, or Pug?
I'm going to go Major.
Rapping. Major?
Major.
Oh, wow.
Because wait. Two things. One, if LeBron is actually rapping, he has the best ghostwriter. Writing a fire verse for him, so it's gonna be good. Second, we might just be looking too much into it. We didn't think Kobe was rapping when he was in the studio with Kanye, but we got some fire tracks just from the inspiration. 2 Chainz just soaking that up. The next album is gonna be A+.
Oh, you're a troll of Bow Wow levels, by the way. Quiet as kept, you win the Bow Wow Award for trolling tonight. All right, now one piece of news just for Bow Wow. You have a new record called Yeah. Is this song Major, Mage, or Pug?
Now, you know I'm going to say it's Major. It's me. You know what I'm saying? With Gucci on it, on the hook. So, of course, you mentioned Gucci. So, you know, it's a new sound. I feel like it's time. You know what I'm saying? I stepped away for about 5 years for TV, 2 years of this and 2 years of 106. So for me, it's just all about having fun, get back in the groove. Like I said, if you do it, you do it. Why not keep doing it? So we're just going to keep doing it.
And I appreciate it because you also stepped away from interviews throughout the last 6 hours and now you came back and joined us.
Yeah, but there wasn't no interview, though. You know, we kicked it. You're the homie, so you know you're good.
I appreciate it.
You know that.
Don't forget to pick up Bow Wow's new single, Yeah, on iTunes or wherever you download music. One thing is for sure, I'm giving tonight's panel a big time major. Give it up for tonight's panel. And in just a second, I'm about to sit down with the one and only ASAP Rocky. But first, let's check in with my guy, A-Rab Music. Producer, director, oh, did I mention rapper? And one of the few dudes with more jobs than me, Harlem's own ASAP Rocky, New York. I believe you know A-Rap Music.
A-Rap.
Yo, first of all, thank you. There's no one more perfect to do the first episode of Open Late.
It's an honor.
Come on,
it's
man.
It's a pleasure.
Going all the way back, I was talking to my wife the other day about when I first talked to you. I believe our first conversation was on Facebook Messenger.
Yes, correct. 2010, 11?
Something like that. A long time ago.
A long time ago. And you reached out like, yo, you're a dope kid, man. I'm going to support you. I like what you're doing.
It's funny. Your buzz kind of crept up. And I actually felt it's so funny in retrospect. At the time, I felt like I was late because I was like, everyone's talking about this ASAP Mob and this ASAP Rocky. Facts. I was like, you need a radio edit of Peso. I think you're going to need this.
Purple Swag.
Or Purple Swag.
Purple Swag. You was the first person to play Purple Swag on the radio.
And anyways, it's just been incredible to watch this whole thing. And here we are, album number 3, man.
Yes, sir. Third time's a charm.
You were going to do this in 2017.
Correct.
So why, it's 2018, why are we here now and still no album?
I think it's one of them things where it's just like, I take proper precautions. And when testing this whole album, it's like about perfect time and everything has to be aligned correctly. So one little thing, one little mishap, one little imperfection could throw off a whole cycle. You know, I would prefer to put out music to change people's moods or uplift or get a feeling or a reaction opposed to just making music to stay relevant for the sake of popularity.
Well, in that vein, you've always been sort of like weird and interesting with your choices for features. You just did it with Moby, the ASAP Forever video. I have never wanted to be high that bad. I barely smoke these days. I got too many jobs. And I saw that, I was like, honey, we need to start getting high again. Take us through that video a little bit. At the beginning, it looked like you had the homage to Atlanta, to unrelated.
I was really pissed off about the Atlanta preview. We actually shot this ASAP Forever video way back in 2017. So yeah, man.
Really?
We wrapped it up in December of 2017.
And then it's just a random thing you see, and it's like, this is the same thing.
Just for that motion, that one part, you know, obviously I was a little, it was unfortunate, but I mean, great minds think alike.
What I love about this record with Moby, you had the one with Rod Stewart. It seems like you're like the blend of you as a human being. Harlem Cat, Jiggy Shit, hip hop, right?
I like how you say Jiggy Shit.
All that shit is you.
Yeah.
But at the same time, you've traveled your life has taken you everywhere. You've known interesting people. So I saw the Rod Stewart feature. I remember that was the first one. I was like, oh, well, Rocky's gonna have a record I don't like. You know, because sometimes those features seem random when people try to pull them up. And yet it worked. It seemed authentic to who you are.
When you read in the header, like, ASAP Rocky featuring so-and-so or vice versa, so-and-so featuring ASAP Rocky, it's just know it was genuine. Just know that, you know? And a lot of times you gotta put features, especially if they like old rock stars and whatnot. Like,
what is it about you and the old rock stars? Like, is there something about the vibe though that you relate to or like?
Cause that's not really alive anymore. As much as we want it to be, that's why I love like Lil Uzi Vert and Playboi Carti and them guys and whatnot. Cause those are like the they under us that like they the new next rock stars for real.
But don't you think they, the generation coming up that you just talked about, Uzi, Carti, Smokey, we'll get to in a little bit. These cats that have come up, don't you think the rock star part of them, some of it comes from actually admiring you guys?
For sure. Ironically. For sure, man, for sure. Without
Are you able to sense though that like you've been around long enough now that the new generation kinda grew up on you, which is kinda crazy.
These are our proteges. Of course.
And you welcome them in. Like that wasn't always a thing though. Sometimes in hip hop, people fought so much against the new generation.
Nah,
you're on a Famous Dex record.
I fought with Famous Dex.
You signed Smokey and yeah. Playboi Carti.
Yes, sir.
So it seemed like a very easy transition for you that sometimes artists aren't always so comfortable with.
I think Yams equipped me for, like, he prepared me for this kind of state subconsciously, just based off the fact that Yams was always about helping people or trying to put somebody else on that he thought was fire.
He was like the A&R of New York, practically.
You know, like, from people on the West Coast, Cutthroat, Joey Fats, anybody in New York, Bodega Bims, he even, like, Flatbush Zombies, anybody, people that he had intentions on signing or just fucking with or just featuring with. It was always for the same purposes and reasons. It was just like, yo, they fire, and people just need to know about this. And fuck with what you like. That's what he always was. I'm always going to put Yams in my shit because he is me. I am him. Yams is ASAP. Yams is worldwide. You know what I'm saying? ASAP is forever.
Are you at this point nostalgic now about things early in your career? I was thinking about that first tour with you, Drake, and Kendrick. And then Cole was on the second leg of that tour.
Yo, we had so much fun back then. I was just thinking about how young K-Dot was. Kendrick was young as hell. Drake was young as hell. He was still dressing like a Canadian. Like, it was
like, he still wearing Roots hoodies.
Back then, it was fun. Like, you know what I'm saying? We was all young. Like, and I'm going to come clean. Like, he reached out at an early age, showed love. And it was like the start of everybody's shit. Like, it was a love thing. It was like, you know what I'm saying? I really met some dudes that I could really be like, I bang with these guys.
Do you think that tour was a nice piece of the early puzzle, right?
Man, it was a beautiful piece of the early puzzle, man. It was fun, man. Like, you can't take the memories, Yams, man. I mean, Chubbs, it's memories, man. You taking me back, bro.
Well, how about this? Hold on. And while going way back then, I thought about how interesting it is. You did fucking Problem, which was the mainstream posse cut of, like, the last decade, maybe? And you probably know where I'm going to go now. And you also did
One Train,
which was...
I knew he was about to say
But it didn't dawn on me till recently how ill that is, because that sums up who you are.
Yeah.
You occupy kind of both worlds.
Yo, it's crazy because it's like Action Bronson, who is a legend.
Yep.
Joey Badass, who is a legend. Big Crit, who is a legend. Yellow Wolf, who is a legend. K-Dot goes without speaking, you know? I hope I'm not missing Danny Brown, who's a legend. Let me never disrespect the God. Can we get some love for Danny Brown? Can y'all get some Danny fucking Brown? I just want to say Danny Brown is one of my spirit animals.
Yo, he is one of my favorite people to get to. When I bump into him, he's one of my favorite people to spend time around. His stories and just general energy.
His energy is a story. Really? Like, you know what I'm saying? You're going to tell a story after you leave with that dude.
You got to ask him about that. Have you ever talked to him about when he performed with at the Gathering of the Juggalos with the Insane Clown Posse?
When he caught head on stage? No, that was the second time. I was there the first time.
Oh, really?
First time was the Fool's Gold Party with A-Track, 2012. Me and Ferg was on stage. Next thing I turned to the side. This nigga Danny Brown get his dick sucked on stage. Some random girl just whipped his shit out, started going crazy. I went back, I'm like, yo, bro, you know that? Man, I know that girl just started sucking my dick. Like, I just was like, fuck it. Like, I was like, damn, bro, that's a rock star.
And you gotta respect the lack of performance anxiety on stage. Like, that's impressive.
I'm like, yo, what is going on right now, yo?
So I admit, I'm gonna call ignorance on this. It came up recently. That there's some sort of weirdness at least alleged weirdness between you and my guy Travis Scott.
Don't say weirdness.
That's how it was portrayed. That's how I felt it was portrayed.
I think, okay, keep going.
So my feeling was, A, you know, sometimes when you have relationship with people, like I'm not aware of what everyone's relationship is with someone else.
Yeah.
So I'm like, oh, I love Rocky, I love Travis. These are two of the people I want on my show. These are two of the people I think have shaped, you guys may be as responsible for shaping culture right now as anyone in the game. So that's all I thought about. And I was like, oh, I hope there's nothing, you know, particularly bad there. But I was ignorant to what it was, if anything.
Are you referring to the Funkmaster Flex thing?
Yeah. He tweeted something. You retweeted that. He then tweeted about Travis, which you didn't reply to.
For sure.
But it led to a conversation.
I think it's like this, right? Like, he's speaking his opinion. It's times when I feel like I've pioneered a lot of shit but don't get acknowledgement from certain people or artists or whatever the case was. I think a lot of people see it too, you know, and I think he was just speaking his opinion. He said what he said, I said facts, you know, that's about it.
But you didn't say facts specifically to the Travis comment.
I don't even know why we talking about Travis Scott right now. No shade.
No shade.
Know? But like, you know.
Because I just feel like in my mind, while I guess maybe he was referring to style, I don't think of you guys musically in similar veins, particularly.
Call it what you will. Axe Flex. You know what I'm saying? Like, I think Travis Scott, you know, he makes cool music and he had a baby. I'm happy for that. Like, it's beautiful. I honestly, like, I'm handsome. I'm single. I'm
facts.
Here,
it's like, all facts. By the way, all super facts. Well, how do you feel? Are you, is fatherhood something you think about yet or not on your radar?
Always.
Really?
Yeah.
What do you think about with regards to it? Like, is it something you yearn for?
I want to leave behind a legacy, you know, a daughter or a son or something, you know. A little me would be fire.
Would you, now you were named after, you were named after an icon. Would you ever, do you have any names that ever pops in your head for this fantasy child? Like, would you ever consider?
Rakim?
Like, either keeping the name going
or name my son Kanye?
Or, hey.
Yo, if I name my son Kanye, like, literally, he's really gonna be born with a big-ass fucking head, like, bigger than mine. Like, it's bad enough I physically have a huge fucking cranium. But the fact that his name would be
Kanye?
And he's ASAP Rocky's son?
Right.
It's fucked up, bro.
But you love Kanye, right?
I love Ye.
Like, I've never really asked you about your relationship with him. What's he like?
I love that Ye embraces what I do and he don't hate. Like, if I do something ill, he'd be like, yo, that was fire, bro. Like, keep going. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, Ye is just inspirational. Pharrell's inspirational. As far as music goes, they changed a lot for me as a kid and a teenager.
Just listening to them.
And being influenced by them, you know?
Who have you not been in the studio with that you would, that maybe would, the idea of that person would make you geek out because you couldn't even picture it?
All right, hold on. Let me think about this.
Marinate on this for a second.
Okay. Any genre.
Any genre.
Okay.
Because we know you like to pick random old white guys. So what random?
Why is it Billy? A random old white guy? Though?
It's like Paul Simon, Billy Joel. I mean, where are we going here?
Hold up. You know, let me think.
Yo, this James Taylor collaboration.
I might have to fuck with Morrissey.
Really?
Yeah. On some Smith shit, man. Just make some emo real, you know, retro infusion motherfucking 2018 shit, man.
But that's an interesting one you mentioned too, because your whole thing's been about testing sounds.
Yes.
So what makes the testing sounds on this coming album, testing, different than prior?
I think with this one, it's more deliberate. I'm experimenting in a more calculated way. Like, I'm trying to make sure that I take precaution to where I'm not just drawing out of the lines all crazy, mixing my colors. I'm still trying to give you a beautiful canvas, but something different, and I want to take a different approach, and I want to challenge the viewer, you know, who's tired of hearing the same old shit. You know, this shit is a cliche at this point. I'm just trying to test my viewers and listeners to see if they're ready to evolve and grow with me. You know, I'm rich. Like, if this album does what it, you know, that's not the attitude. This is going to be an amazing fucking album. You know, I'm going to hopefully change a lot of people's lives again and hopefully people will make better music and influence me to make even better music.
That's dope, bro. All right, before I let you get up out of here.
You kicking me out?
No, no. They're
that's
telling me in my ear that you have lots of other things to do. Don't you dare.
That's messed up,
you can
yo.
Be my criminal coach.
I just got here, yo.
Yo, Rocky wants to stay for a minute, cuz.
Me and A-Rab ain't even get to catch up.
Nothing.
You know this is my brother right here.
Of course.
We go way back.
This is the history is there. Now, speaking of going way back, we're going to dig in the crates with A$AP Rocky. Edition of Digging in the Crates. Shout out to Diamond D, Showbiz, the entire DITC, Fat Joe. But this is what I do. I dig in the crates. That's my hobby. This is what I do. So we figure bring up a crate of records and put in some items that mean something
okay.
to the guests. So I'm going to take, let's start with an easy one.
Okay. Paid in full.
This is your no-brainer, obviously. But when you see this record, what do you think about?
I think about me. I'm named after Rakim Allah himself. My sister's name is Erica B. Here's Eric B.
Which is the most, by the way, it's cool that you're named Rakim. The fact that your sister's name is Erica B makes your mom the most hip hop person on planet Earth. It's crazy.
Yo, this is so fly. They got all the chains and money and shit.
What is it about Rakim, though, that besides, obviously, that's in your blood, what do you love about him as an artist?
What I love about Rakim is just like during his era, there was only really one other guy that people always compare him to, and that was like Big Daddy Kane. But like Rakim just, he had flow. You know, he had pizzazz. Like, he was that nigga. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, Rakim was a bad motherfucker, you feel me? Like, and I feel like at the time, like, it wasn't a more legit, honorable motherfucker to be named after than Rakim Allah.
Yeah, couldn't agree with you more. All right, let me get that one. Let's keep it moving. How about...
Oh, shit.
How about this guy right here? This is another, you talk about
man
the complex
the
all-stars, like people who matter in this world. You got Rocky.
Fucking floors.
And you got this guy.
To the God. This guy right here is a fucking God. You understand me? Like, at the end of the day, man, we tip our hat off. We salute Kid Cudi. He's a G and a genius, man. Like, he influenced a lot of my shit, too. And I'm always going to, you know, show love and admit that, man. I got mad love for the Cutter. That's my brother right there, yo. Yes. Like
do you that. Consider them to be in the era just before you? The
yes,
one
I
right
do.
Before
yes,
you?
Yes, I do. Like Charles Hamilton.
Yeah.
You know, the Freddie Gibbs.
Yeah.
Kid Cudi.
Oh, there's that famous freestyle. There's Cudi and Asher Roth freestyle from DJ Enough from, like, 2010.
Shout out to Asher. A legend. A legend. Ooh, bring that on here, man.
Talk about this Get Rich or Die Trying.
I ain't gonna hold you. This lenticular cover is crazy. First off, the art on this, you can't tell from when y'all are standing, but like, I never saw this cover in real life.
I want everyone to know that's the second time I've heard this man say lenticular today. And I don't know what that means.
It's like, basically, you know how like, back in the days when you were a kid, you seen the graphic, and when you move, it'll like kind of change a little bit, like a holographic card. Like, that's like lenticular.
Where does, in New York history, where does this album belong?
Top five. Top fucking five. What you mean?
Yeah, this moment was...
Top five. He changed... What, if A$AP Rocky changed the world, man, 50... What? Right. He had people wearing bulletproof vests. And they was... Like, he had stockbrokers going to work with G-Unit tank tops and do-rags and shit. Jit. You feel me? Shout out to 50, man.
Shout out to 50.
Shout out 50, man.
Hey, shout out to you. Make some noise for A$AP Rocky. His new album, Testing, is dropping soon. And now, Rocky, you ready? We got something special to do.
Let's do it.
Here to perform his now gold single, Plug Walk, Off the World is Yours. Make some noise for Rich the Kid.
Yo, read about it. Hey. Huh? Ooh. Hey. Hey, plug walk. Ooh, ooh. Hey, I don't even understand how to put my plug talk. Ooh. Hey, hey. Pick him up in his face, cool. I don't let my plug walk. Pull up in his face, cool. Hey, hey. New freak had to cut my other little bitch off. Ooh. Hey, 50K, you could come and book a nigga for a plug walk. You can't reach me. Wait.
Space coupe like E.T. Hey, it's the plug tryna call me. I was up trapping early in the morning. Ooh, running away like a durag. Hey, pussy nigga calling for his boo back. Hey, plug walk Gucci on my shoe rack. Walk up in the house till I ran into the plug. Till I ran into the mud. I done ran into some racks. I done ran into your girl. Hey, why the plug show me love? I done came up from a dub. Huh, plug walk. Hey, 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 I don't even understand how to fuck my plug talk. Hey, 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 pick him up in the space coupe. I don't let my plug walk, pull up in the space coupe. Hey, hey, new freak had to cut my other little bitch off. Ooh, hey, 50K, you could come and book a nigga for a plug walk. Big ol' Bentley is a spaceship. Call me on my phone, I don't say shit. Hey, cause I make money when I talk. Bitch, I'm a boss, take a loss. Hey, I can introduce it to the plug. This ain't no Henny in my cup, little bitch. Hey, stay down, now the racks up. Hey, what? Hey, she gon' let me fuck ass up. Plug, I stuff keys in a Louis V. Fuck 12, I'm a G, ain't no stopping me. Hey, and my wrist is on overseas. Hey, rich nigga, you can't talk to me. Plug, whoa. Hey, hey, hey. I don't even understand how to fuck my plug talk. Hey, hey, pick him up in the space coupe. I don't let my plug walk, pull up in the space coupe. Ooh, hey, new freak had to cut my other little bitch out. Ooh, hey, 50K, you can come and book a nigga for a plug walk. You did? Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yes, one time, Rich the Kid. Make some noise, New York City. All right, first of all, congratulations. The World Is Yours is out right now.
Out. Get the album.
Quavo, Rick Ross, Weezy, Breezy, Jay Critch. It's a crazy album, and you said it's the best album of 2018.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so here's my question for you. What is going to be the second best album of 2018?
Jay Critch album.
You dig. I love that. Okay, okay. Now, last time I saw you, which key did I steal from you? It was your...
Bentley?
The Bentley key.
Yeah,
so I know you like fly shit.
Yeah.
What's the newest piece of fly shit that you've gotten?
I got a fucking a pinky ring.
They're not wearing it.
Yeah, I don't got it on right
that
now.
That was super anticlimactic.
Yo, I got a pinky ring, but it's not on right now.
Yo, congrats, man. Thank you very much. Make some noise one more time for Rich the Kid.
Yeah, the money way.
We gotta get out of here. Big thanks to Rich the Kid and all of my guests tonight. That's it. Open Late is now closed. We'll see y'all next Thursday at 10 p.m. right here on Complex. And before we go, just one thing for the haters to chew on for a minute. I know everyone's been in their feelings about Tupac lately. And while he may be hip-hop's greatest icon ever, he's not in my top 10 favorite MCs. Oh. Discuss. Good night, everyone. Oh.